School. I'm your science teacher. We are learning chapter 6, tissues. Now, as what we have just completed yesterday about permanent tissues, now we are going to see the next type of tissue is a complex permanent tissue. Now, again, as what I said earlier also, permanent tissues are of two types: simple permanent tissue, complex permanent tissue. Simple permanent tissue we just saw. Now, let's see complex permanent tissue. Now, see, these tissues are different types of tissue we discuss, right? Now you are allowed to make one type of tissues only which look each other, which we call it as a simple permanent tissue. But complex permanent tissue are made up of more than one type of cell exactly. In simple, it has only one type of cells which changes from one to another. But in complex, they itself has two types of cells. One is xylem and another is a phloem. Right, these are the two. So complex permanent tissue again are divided into two. One is xylem and other is phloem. Now xylem and phloem, we are going to discuss a little more on it. Okay, what that exactly they do. Now they are two conducting tissue. Conducting tissue, make sure you understand this thing. Conduct means what? They must be transporting one thing to another, from one place to another. So basically they are conducting tissue and vascular bundle, means it increases the thickness and all. So xylem and phloem are complex permanent tissue. Is a distinguished feature of the complex plant. One of them made possible the survival in a terrestrial environment. So basically because of this tissue, in terrestrial environment the survival is possible. Now let's see about one of them each turn by turn. Xylem. Xylem has many things into it. It is not single. It is made up of tracheates, vessels, xylem parenchyma and xylem fibers. Now I'm going to teach you each and everyone what is the role. What does tracheates and vessel do? Tracheates have a thick wall and are dead cells when mature. So when they mature, it will become dead. Now they become tubular structures. Now tracheates and vessels are of tubular structures. This allows to transport water and minerals vertically. So basically, who transport water and minerals vertically? Vertically, do you understand? Right. So they transport water and minerals from the bottom to the top, right? Vertically. Parenchyma stores food. So basically, tracheates and vessels transport water and minerals vertically. Parenchyma stores food. Xylem fibers are mainly supportive in function. Supportive in function. Xylem fibers are mainly supportive in function. So everybody is playing different role. In xylem, they have tracheates, vessels, xylem parenchyma, and xylem fibers. Tracheates and vessels, what they do? Tracheates and vessels are tubular structures. They transport waters and minerals vertically. Parenchyma stores food and xylem fibers are mainly supportive in function. Now let us talk about phloem. Phloem is made up of 5 types of cells. Sheath cells, sheath tubes, companion cells, phloem fibers and phloem parenchyma. 5 things. Sheath cells, sheath tubes, companion cells, phloem fibers and phloem parenchyma. They are made up of 5 types of cells. Now let's see what each and everybody do. Sheath tubes and tubular cells are perforated walls. So basically they are forming a wall like structures. Phloem again transport food from where? Leaves to other parts of the cell. Now you know leaves do photosynthesis and from that they produce food and energy. That is transport from leaves to other parts of the plants. Except phloem fibers, other phloem cells are living cells. So phloem cells are living cells. If you see this one, right? Can you see tracheate, vessel, xylem, parenchyma? This is how they look when you see it in detail. Sheath tube, sheath cells, phloem parenchyma, companion cell. This is how they look it. So if you see it properly, this is how they look. So what we learn today is complex permanent tissue. Complex permanent tissues are made up of more than one type of cell. Simple permanent tissue is only made up of one type of cells only. More than one type of cell, complex one. Xylem and phloem are two types of complex permanent tissue, right? They are conducting tissue, as what you know, we just saw, okay, it transport one thing to another. So basically that is the reason. Tracheas and vessels are tubulars. They transport minerals and water. Parenchyma stores food. Xylems are mainly supportive in function. Phloem is again five types of cells, right? Shoe tubes and are tubular cells, perforated balls. Phloem transport food from leaves to other parts of the plant. Okay, so I hope you are getting what I am trying to say. So with this we have completed plant tissue. Now next session we are going to see about animal tissue. Okay, so that's it for the day. Thank you so much.